It's a question of taste.
Tastes like Coke.
It tastes like Pepsi.
Tastes like a diet soda.
Tastes different.
What they're tasting is a new cola called Jolt, and we found some real pop experts.
What you tend to do is compare this with Coca-Cola. That's your first instinct.
Sure.
And how does it compare to Coke?
Exactly.
Is it like a Coke? And
yeah.
From my standpoint, it's similar to a Coke, but there's something in there. There's one flavor ingredient that makes it just slightly different.
He's right. Jolt boldly proclaims that it contains all the sugar and twice the caffeine.
There's a little bit of a grape hue to it, all the sugar and twice the caffeine.
Great! Great stuff, Harv.
It's the caffeine. This is wonderful!
And that's just the reaction the Jolt makers are counting on. While the major soft drink makers are going for light, diet, sugar-free, caffeine-free, and 10% juice, Jolt says phooey to it all.
Jolt Cola, is this stuff for real?
Who puts this out?
Jolt was created in Rochester, New York, by a retired Canada Dry bottler and his son, the president of Jolt Company Incorporated, C.J. Rapp.
We started in 1979 on the recipe itself. We call it a formula. And we began right in 1979, and we went to what they call a flavor house, which expertise in enhancing flavors. And we described really that we wanted to make it back with 100% sugar and twice the caffeine, and we want a great tasting cola. And it took about 4 years in entirety to get it to this point.
Jolt sales in the Rochester area jumped from 24,000 cans in the first week to 100,000 in the fourth week. The news reached a Vancouver company called BDC, and for a bargain price, they bought the Canadian rights to Jolt. CJ Rapp and BDC's vice president, Bob Bell, would be happy with a 1% market share. Coca-Cola has an estimated 47% share, and Pepsi claims a 30% share. But that little 1% share would still mean $200 million a year for CJ and $20 million for Bob Bell and friends.
Well, our demographics show that there's three main areas. There's the yuppie area that'll buy it because it's something new and trendy. Then there's the hardcore flavor drinkers, the people who are missing. You know, they won't quit smoking, they won't quit drinking, and anything that's supposed to be bad for you is good for them. They'll do it. And then the children, because they think it's a little naughty and a little risqué, so they're going to get interested in it too.
How many end up buying it on a regular basis will only tell in terms of the taste.
We took a sample to Canadian market expert Len Kubas, who says they'll probably get that 1%.
I think it's a nifty idea. I'm not sure. I don't think it's going to cause Coke to quake in its boots, but it will take a small share of the market. That for the fiends who really want caffeine, for the fiends who want a more solid body to their Coke, I think, or Coca-Cola, I think this is going to be a good substitute.
You should be able to buy Jolt by New Year's, if you're interested.
No, I don't like it at all.
You don't like it
no,
at all?
No, I don't. And I think it's pretty ridiculous.
I don't think people would like to ask for Jolt. The name just doesn't sound right.
I don't think I would buy it. I think there's such a trend of the other drinks. Now there's going to be a market, perhaps, and young kids that want to be different. It's like the same kid that would smoke a cigarette, perhaps, but not for me.
Thank you very much.
You're very welcome.
Do we get to keep this?
Oh, yeah, wait, not for you, Ava. In the meantime, would you like some more?
Just a bit.
Yeah.